I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. Here we go. We're reading God's word. We're doing what we heard. We're spreading God's love from John chapter 3. We're memorizing scripture. We don't hide it in our hearts. And when we're old, we will never depart. Why? I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB set. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB set. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. Righteous seed is who we strive to be. KBKidz affecting the world around us positively. We are growing day by day. We are watching what we say. We are kingdom builder kids, and we're here to pave the way. Hey, we are kingdom builders, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say,
hey kids, why are we still standing here? It's this way to KB.
Good morning, KB kids, and welcome to worship today. My name is Miss D, and guess what? It is volume number 124. Yes, it is volume number 124, and I am excited that you are joining me for KB kids virtual worship. How have you been? It's been a little bit since I've seen you guys now that we've started our new format of every fifth Sunday, but I hope you are well, and I hope you are taking advantage of the other 123 sessions that are on our KBKidz YouTube channel. So if you haven't yet, go ahead and take some time to like and subscribe and hit that notifications button so you know when a brand new episode hits the airways. Guys, happy Resurrection Day! Happy Easter! I hope you are excited this morning. I hope that you are ready to celebrate the risen Savior. I love Easter time. I love just remembering the sacrifice that God has given us. It gives me a sense of gratitude, and it just makes me want to sing out and thank God for all the blessings that He has bestowed on my life. I hope you guys are excited. We have some exciting things for in-person KB today, so I hope you guys are ready to go. All right, we are going to go ahead and get started. And because it is Easter, our theme for today is the Easter story. So we're going to talk a little bit more about that. And I know we are going to have a lot of fun. We have all of our favorites here today, so you don't want to miss out. But you know what we got to do to start off with, right? Of course, we have to say our confessions. Why, Misty? I'll tell you why. Because the Bible says that we can have whatsoever we say, what we say with our mouth, based on the word of God, and it will come to pass. So we want to confess good things about ourselves. We want to say what the word says about us, and not what our friends say, not what the media says, not what you see on social media. We don't care about those things. We want to know what God says about us, because that is who we are as kingdom builder kids. All right, so go ahead and stand up on your feet. It's a lot better to say confessions when you're standing. We had a KB friend say our confessions for us today, so follow along and say it with us.
I love God, I love the Lord Jesus Christ, the blessed Holy Spirit, the things of the Spirit, the Word of God, the Word of God, and the people of God. And I love everything else, and I love the world. I put on the whole arm of God that I can stand against the devil's scheme. That I am the salvation, the shield of peace, the belt of truth, the breastplate of righteousness, the shield of faith, and the sword of the Spirit, and then the Word of God. And I will use the Word to knock down, to crush, and to stop anything that is not of God. I'm a winner, born to be a leader, the start to catch a free, and lead man in the path to righteousness, but his namesake. Why? Because I am a righteous seed.
Bye. later, guys.
Awesome, awesome. All right, we have started off with a strong start, but we are not finished yet. We have so much yet to do today, and we're going to kick it off with one of our favorites, story time with Grandma Sandy. Grandma Sandy has a special Easter message for you, so check it out. It's story time with Grandma Sandy.
It's story time!
Yay! Hi, boys and girls. Welcome to Story Time with Grandma Sandy. I am so excited about reading the Bible with you today. Now come on, go and get your Bible and meet me at the rocking chair.
Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive, my Jesus is alive. Alive, alive, alive forevermore. My Jesus is alive.
Ah, hi boys and girls. Welcome back to Story Time with Grandma Sandy. Do you know why I am so excited? If you said because it's Resurrection Day that we're celebrating, you were right. Happy Resurrection Day, boys and girls. That's something to be excited about because our Jesus, he's alive and he's no longer dead. Hallelujah. Well, let's get right into our story. Thank you so much for coming back to listen to Story Time with Grandma Sandy. Today, we're going to be reading a book called The Easter Fix. This is by Steph Williams. A true story from the Bible. This is the story of how God sent someone to fix everything. That someone was called Jesus. But some people didn't like how Jesus fixed things. They closed their eyes. They closed their hearts. They said no to God. They put Jesus on a cross to die. A cross for bad people. They put his body in a grave and shut the door tight. Was it the end? 1, 2, 3 days later. What? When Jesus' friends came back, the big stone was open. Jesus is alive! Glory! Oh, he's alive! He's alive! He's all better. Blinding bright angels told them, don't you remember? Jesus told you he had to die and come back alive again? It wasn't Jesus who said no to God. It wasn't Jesus who wasn't kind. It wasn't Jesus who should be put on a cross. But Jesus died for us, for you and for me. Jesus didn't come just to fix a few things. He gave his life to fix the thing that makes everything broken, our broken friendship with God. Now, anyone who believes in Jesus is friends with God. He came alive again to show us how one day in heaven, everything will be fixed for God's friends forever. This story comes from Luke 24, verses 1 through 8, but it starts right back at the beginning of the Bible. Here it tells us that God made a perfect world, but that people disobeyed his rules. They said no to God. They were not friends with God anymore. And because of this, the whole world became broken. Sadness, hatred, illness, and death came into our lives. We cannot live forever anymore. Our broken friendship with God is the thing that makes everything broken. But someone was coming to fix it. The Bible tells us that God came into the world as a person, Jesus Christ, with no guilt of his own to pay for. Jesus paid the punishment for when we have said no to God and his rules. The punishment of death, the most broken of brokenness. Now, if we believe in Jesus, we can be friends with God. But Jesus did not stay dead. He is not here, said the angels, by his grave, verse 6. He came alive again, the first person ever to do so. He is like the first fruits on a tree, showing us that the punishment of death was paid and that God will bring his friends back to life forever too in a world that is all fixed. Some people did not love God and still said no, closing their hearts to the one God sent. But Jesus welcomes everyone who comes to him and says yes to God. Because of Jesus, we can be friends with God forever. Boys and girls, I hope that you are one of those that will say yes to God, that you have given your heart to Jesus, and if you have, you will live with him for eternity. Now, if you have not given your heart to Jesus, pray this prayer with me. Heavenly Father, I come to you in Jesus' name, asking you to forgive me of my sin. I have done wrong. I have disobeyed you. I have said no to you. But today, I want to say yes. Come into my heart. Live with me forever. And take me to be with Jesus and God and the Holy Spirit after I leave this earth forever. Thank you for hearing my prayer in Jesus' name. Boys and girls, if you prayed that, write to Kingdom Builders Kids. There will be an address on the screen. Tell us that you gave your heart to Jesus today and you said yes to God. Now always remember, Grandma Sandy loves you, but Jesus loves you more.
It's story time!
Awesome. Thank you so much, Grandma Sandy. We appreciate you and we appreciate all that you bring to our KBKidz virtual worship program. All right, guys, it is time for praise and worship. Always one of my favorite times, but today it's even more sweeter because we get to celebrate the risen Savior. And we're going to get started with the good one. He is alive. And that's what we're proclaiming today. Our God is alive. 1, 2, 3. Jesus is alive. Let's sing it together.
One, two, three. Jesus is alive. One, two, three. Jesus is alive. He died for you and me. But on day three, Jesus rose again. Jesus is alive. One, two, three. Jesus is alive. He died for you and me. But on day three, Jesus rose again. Jesus is alive. God loved the world.
Everyone.
God loves everyone.
God loves.
Jesus rose again. Jesus is alive. Jesus rose again. Jesus is alive. Jesus rose again. Now Jesus is alive.
Awesome. That's always a fun one. We're going to continue on with one of my favorites, God's Not Dead. Can you say it with me? God's not dead. That's right. He is alive. The tomb is empty, and we are declaring it today. God's not dead. Let's sing it together.
Living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead.
least, we are singing Amazing Grace. God has given us so much grace. He sent his son to die on the cross for us, even when we didn't deserve it. He has given us so much grace and so much mercy. So we want to shout it for the rooftops today, how amazing his grace is. Let's sing it together.
Sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
Did you know with Mother Crouch?
Hello, KBKidz. Yes, this is your beloved Mother Crouch. I am back. I have a good question for you today. Can you tell me what day it is? What Sunday are we celebrating? Let me see. If you said Easter, you are correct. And some of you might even say, well, Mother Crouch, we're celebrating Resurrection Sunday. Woohoo! On that, you are also correct. And I want to share some more nuggets with you, what I found about Easter. Now, you can locate this, and maybe you want to have your parents read it to you, in Luke chapter 23, which talk about Jesus being crucified. And then Luke 24, which talk about Jesus' resurrection. But let's see what the dictionary say what Easter is. So listen up. In Christianity, the day is a remembrance of the sacrifices of Jesus Christ. And then it says, even the eggs that people died, D-Y-E, for Easter, symbolize new life and new birth. But we're going to talk about what Jesus did for us. Resurrection Sunday, children, He rose from the dead. And I don't want to take it for granted that some of you all have received him. So you know what? Just say, Lord, come into my heart, forgive me of my sins, and I receive you now. But I want to share something else with you that most of us do along with Easter. I want to answer this question, because some of y'all may have this question in your mind, and let Mother Crouch read it to you. What do Easter, when Easter, what do eggs and the bunnies have to do with Easter? And what do they have to do with the resurrection of Jesus? Well, here it comes. Spoiler alert, nothing. Bunnies, Easter's, the egg, the Easter gift, a fluffy yellow chick, and garden hats all stem from pagan roots. They were incorporated into the celebration of Easter separately from the Christian tradition of honoring the day Jesus Christ rose from the dead. And let me share this too, what I found out about the Easter bunny. That it originated among the German Protestant in the 17th century when a children's storybook mentioned an Easter hare, H-A-R-E, which is a rabbit, right? Bringing eggs to good children. This rabbit was, and still today is called Osterhase. That's O-S-T-E-R-H-A-S-E. And this magical rabbit would lay colored eggs the night before Easter for the children to find. That's where they got that from. But guess what? I wonder, can any of you tell me what animal in the Bible is a symbol for Christianity? I hear the clock ticking. Can anyone tell me? Okay, I will tell you. It is the lamb. And let me find this verse that I want to read to you. It's located in St. John, the first chapter, verse 29. I got my Bible. And it reads as follows. The next day, John saw Jesus coming towards him and said, Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. And he said, This is he of whom I said, After me comes a man who is preferred before me, for he was before me. Yes, the Lamb of God. That's who Jesus represents in the Bible. And children, I want you guys to remember, we talked about Easter and what Easter is all about. It was about the crucifixion and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And you can find that in Luke chapter 23 and 24. I also want to encourage you, because I know we're going to have Easter hunt. I can remember when I was a young girl, we used to have an Easter hunt during Sunday school, and I was so excited about it. But don't forget that Jesus was the one that died for us, and Jesus the one that rose for our sins and justification. So until now, you guys know it, and you know what I always say. One of my favorite scripture is, what is it? You got it. Psalms 119, verse 11. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I may not sin against thee. So until next time, KB Kids, keep on learning.
Did you know? With Mother Crouch.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Mother Crouch. We appreciate you dropping wisdom on us and making sure that we are staying in the Word of God and explaining and breaking down some of the things that we may not understand. All right, guys, it is scripture memory time. It is time to hide the Word of God in our hearts, just as Mother Crouch always encourages us to do. So our scripture from today comes from Romans 5, verse 8, and this is what it says. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Now, this is such a powerful scripture. You know, sometimes you don't always believe when people tell you things, right? You know, someone says, oh yeah, I'm gonna give you this, or oh yeah, I'm gonna come and do this. But you know, sometimes as people, you know, we make mistakes and we fail and we don't always do what we say we're going to do. I know for myself, I try really hard not to tell people I'm going to do things that I don't think I'm going to get to, but I always have the good intentions. And I'll tell, you know, sometimes I'll tell my nephews, hey, I'm going to do something for you.
I'm going to send you this story or something that you're waiting for, and then something will happen or I'll get busy that day and I'll forget to do it. Now, luckily, they don't really get on me too bad, and they're always understanding. It's okay, Auntie. We know, you know, you're busy. We know you tried your best, and we know you'll get it done as soon as you can. And they're very gracious to me, and I appreciate that. But, you know, as you get older, sometimes you're like, you know what? I don't trust these people, because what they're demonstrating to me is not that they're going to do what they've said, but in fact, they're going to let me down. And so sometimes it's hard to believe people when they say things, especially when they let you down. So I love the beginning of the scripture, but this is how God demonstrates his love. So in order for us to understand and truly know that God loves us, he did something very special for us. He said, even when we were sinners. Now, what does it mean to be a sinner? That means we've done things against others, against God, even against ourselves that are contrary to what God wants us to do. The Bible says all have sinned, Romans 3:23, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. So newsflash, we are all sinners. But, I love that, but this is how God demonstrates his love, that when we were still sinners, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. So he didn't wait for us to get our lives together. He didn't wait for us to be worthy, but he said, you know what, Devonna, even though you are wrong in this, and you are wrong in this, and you are wrong in this, I love you so much that I am still going to take all of it away. I'm going to wash it away and make you as white as snow. You know, here in the Midwest, here in Chicago, we know what snow looks like. And snow is at its best when it's coming down. Because once it hits the ground, it's all dirty and gross and slick and makes, you know, for terrible driving and that much. But when it's coming down, that's what I enjoy it the most, especially when I'm not driving. And just looking at it, you know, across, you know, a big field, and it's just white, pure white. And that's what God says. He makes us white as snow. And what covers that sin? The blood of Christ. Even when we were in the midst of doing the wrong thing, even though he knew that we were going to continue to sin throughout our lives, he said, I love you this much that I'm going to send my son, my only son, to die for you, to take away that sin so that one day you can be with me. So I love this. I love the story of the resurrection. I love the story of Easter because it reminds me that I am not worthy, but God loved me enough to still rescue me. Let's go over it one more time. Romans 5 verse 8, it says, but God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. If you have never accepted him into your heart, I encourage you to do so. We just, Grandma Sandy just led us through a prayer, allowing us to do so. If you've never done that, I encourage you to do so, so that you can partake in the grace and you can partake in the demonstration that God has done for you and for me. Amen? Amen. All right, guys, it is time for a movement break. It is time for Sergeant Dad Fitness, and Sergeant Dad is going to make sure we are fit and we are ready for that Easter celebration a little bit later. All right, take it away, Sergeant Dad Fitness.
Are you ready to get fit and strong? Let's turn the music up and move along. Don't give up, don't give in. Keep it going from beginning to end.
Hey, KBKidz, Sergeant Dad here. I have all my friends here to help us join in. We hope that you guys had a great spring break and that you're having a great Holy Week. Who's ready for Easter? You guys ready for Easter?
Yeah!
We all know what Easter's about. It's about the risen Savior. But also, it's about having a little fun and giving God praise. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to have a little fun, do some exercise, and give God praise through our body. So, you know what to do. We're going to stretch out, and then we're going to get into our exercise. You guys ready?
Yeah!
All right. Yeah. First stretch we're going to do. All right, gonna put your arm in front of you, cross your body, and we're gonna do some stretches. All right. All right, guys. You guys feeling good? You guys feeling good? Okay. Good, good. All right, let's cross back over to the other side. Where did you guys go for spring break? Hope you enjoyed yourself. Got some sun, got a little relaxing from school. All right, let's put our left leg forward, put your right leg back, okay? Again, you relax from school, just decompress so you can start, finish the year strong. All right, cross over, switch. Good job, good job. Enjoying yourself. All right, what do you guys want to have for Easter? What do you guys want to have? Eggs. All right. Good job. Good job. All right. Spread your legs shoulder width apart. We're going to just reach to the back. Stretch our legs out. Let's put these little legs in exercise. We want to make sure our legs are nice and comfortable and loose. So you see eggs. We're going to have like some lamb and broccoli. Oh, coming back up. Ew, gross. It's delicious. It's a healthy food, right? Okay. One last exercise. We're doing rotations, right? Rotation. Put your arms like this. Start the back, we're gonna rotate to the front. Ready, do five. Ready, set, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Stop, going backwards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, good job, good job. All right, here we go, guys. Our first exercise is the jumping jacks. We're gonna have some fun, right? We'll do 10 jumping jacks. On my count, ready, guys? 1, 2, 3, begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job, guys. We're gonna go right into our second exercise. We're gonna do the push-ups. 10 push-ups, you guys ready? Are you ready? 10 push-ups, ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job, guys. Good job. All right, we got two more to go. All right, the next exercise we're going to do is, you know what we're going to do? He doesn't know what we're going to do. We'll do the air squat. Ready?
I was going to say that.
What? Okay, here we go. We'll do 10. Ready? Set, begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's go down. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job, good job. Ready for the last exercise?
Yeah.
All right, we're working our abs. Get rid of that candy, those eggs we're eating. Candy, eat that broccoli. All right, last one's gonna be the flutter kick, all right? Get down, here we go. 10, all right? Ready, begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good job, good job. Clap it up, guys. Good job. You clap it up, you did a great job. I'm so glad you got to join us today. Again, continue to eat healthy, be healthy, drink lots of water, get lots of rest, and do great. Don't quit, just do it. Talk to Dad, out. Hey!
Are you ready to get fit and strong? Let's turn the music up and move along. Don't give up, don't give in. Keep it going from beginning to end.
We are back, and I hope you have enjoyed your session with Sergeant Dad. I hope you got your heart pumping and you are ready to continue on with our program. All right, it is lesson time, and it's time to get into our lessons and hear what God has to say to us today. So today I have a little demonstration for you during lesson time, and we are talking about the Easter story. And what is the Easter story? The Easter story starts right around Christmas time, right? When Jesus was born and he went through his life and he went through his ministry. And now we're at the part where he is preaching and he's teaching and he's telling people about God. And he's asking people to repent and to believe in him as God's son. And so eventually he gets into trouble, right? And he is crucified and he's killed. and he's put into the grave. But the story doesn't end there, right? The story doesn't end there. In 3 days, the stone is miraculously rolled away, and Jesus is not there. He is alive. And, you know, sometimes you might say, well, that was a long time ago, and that was in biblical times, and I don't know if this story really applies to me. I don't really understand how it has to do with me now. Now, during scripture memory, we talked about how sometimes we are sinners, right? When we come into this world, it's almost like we come into this world, like, you know, with a blank slate, right? I have a blank plate here. And we're just, you know, a small part of the world. So I have a little penny here, and I'm just going to put this penny, you know, right here in the middle. And we're talking about how, you know, we go through our lives, and we just said Romans 3:23 says that we are all sinners. And you know what? Sometimes sin overwhelms us so much. We're arguing with our siblings. We're telling lies when we don't want to be doing it. We're taking things that don't belong to us. We're looking at people's tests when we didn't study our homework. We're doing all these things that are contrary to the word of God. And eventually, you know, all this sin continues to, you know, to control our lives. And all of a sudden, all we can see is the sin that's around us. All we can see is the sin that is, you know, penetrating our lives, the sin that is covering us up. And we don't know what to do. You know, we ask God to forgive us, and we say, this is going to be the last time, and this is when I'm going to stop. But we can't do it on our own. But we talked about God's demonstration earlier, right? We talked about how God demonstrates his love for us. And he died for our sins because he wanted to take them away from us so we can be washed clean. So right now, we are this penny that's in deep in the water of sin, and we need someone to rescue us. And so the Bible says that Jesus is the light of the world. So I have a candle here, and I'm just going to set this candle here right on top of our sins. And if Jesus is the light of the world, right, he is coming to demonstrate his love for us. And so I'm going to light my candle because he is the light of the world. He is the one that is far reaching, and he can bring everybody to himself. He draws men to himself. And you know what he does? He makes a covering for us. His blood that was shed makes a covering for our lives. And so when Jesus comes in, and when Jesus takes over, and when we invite Christ into our hearts, he becomes this covering over us, and he takes away our sins. So as Jesus is the light of the world, our sins are taken away, our sins are reduced, and all of a sudden, we no longer have to do it on our own. We no longer have to worry about being dead in our sins and being bogged down with condemnation. The Bible says there is now no more condemnation for them who are in Christ Jesus. When Christ comes into our lives, our sin is covered up, it's reduced, it's sucked away, and we are white and clean as snow. And that's only when we accept Christ into our life. So the story of Easter is Christ demonstrating a love that we have to first accept. If we don't accept his love, then we can't partake in it. So we have to accept Christ's love, and then he can take away all of our sins. We're going to continue on, and we have a special treat today. Instead of our traditional puppet show, we have a throwback of a Reader's Theater that we did a couple years ago with some of our KB friends for Easter. I wanted to show you guys that, and if you see yourself, you can laugh at yourself and how young you used to look. But we'll check out the Reader's Theater Easter program, and then we'll check out our animated video, and we'll be right back.
Hosanna, Hosanna. Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Welcome, everyone. I am so glad you have joined our Reader's Theater. I will be your guide, and as we journey together through the story of Easter, our story starts in Jerusalem, where Jesus and his disciples wait.
Jesus is welcomed with open arms, and the crowd even lays down palm trees for his entry on a donkey, shouting, "Hosanna!
Hosanna! Hosanna! Hosanna!"
Unfortunately, it doesn't last long. The religious leaders, or the Pharisees, have something evil in store. The Pharisees decides to pay one of Jesus' disciples, Judas, to turn Jesus over to him. Jesus knows his time is running short, so after dinner with his disciples, Jesus decides to hide in the Garden of Gethsemane to pray. The disciples fall asleep, but Jesus is awake and deep in prayer. He prays for a fate better than this, though he knows that it is what has to be done. So Judas and the officer come to arrest Jesus, but he is already expecting it. Luckily, the arrest did not get ugly. The trial takes hours and there's no conclusion. Jesus has been accused of blasphemy, but there's no proof. The crowd is relenting, yelling, "Crucify him!" Pilate has no choice but to crucify Jesus. So on that day, Jesus is crucified on the cross. His body is buried, and for 3 days, it seems like all hope is lost. Mary Magdalene, a good friend of Jesus, comes to the grave to pay her respects. But to her surprise, she finds the stone rolled away and the body is gone. Mary tells the disciples, and together they make sure. And sure enough, the stone is rolled away and the body is gone. It's a miracle. Jesus is alive. He has defeated death and stands strong. Jesus tells them to go and make disciples of every nation. He leaves the disciples with the message and a new mission to go and make disciples. Isn't the Easter story a marvel? God sent Jesus down as a baby, and Jesus grew up perfect and sinless. Even though he didn't deserve it, Jesus died on the cross for our sins. And because of that, we are now blameless in our sin and can join the Lord in heaven. That is, if you believe. The end.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus washes his disciples' feet. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles like calming storms. And even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
At this time, the Jewish people were celebrating a festival called Passover that had been celebrated since the time of Moses, when God brought his people out of Egypt. So Jesus and his disciples went to Jerusalem to celebrate. Jesus had 12 men who followed him through his ministry. They were called his disciples. Jesus and his disciples gathered for one final meal together. Jesus got up from the table, took off his robe, and began to wash his disciples' feet. Jesus loved his disciples, and he knew the time was coming for him to leave them and return to heaven. When Jesus came to Peter, he said,
Wait.
Are you going to wash my feet? Jesus said, You don't understand what I'm doing now, but someday you will.
No.
Peter said, You will never wash my feet. But Jesus then told him that unless he washed his feet, he would not belong to him.
Okay.
Then Peter said, Then wash my hands and head as well, not just my feet. But Jesus told him that was not necessary. He just needed to wash his feet for Peter to become clean. So Jesus finished washing their feet and said that the disciples should do to others as he had done for them. He told them to follow the example that he had set for them, to serve each other and not think of themselves as greater than any other. Then God would bless them for doing as Jesus had taught them to do. Stories of the Bible. Jesus prays. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like walking on water.
Oh, hey guys.
And even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
At this time, the Jewish people were celebrating a festival called Passover that had been celebrated since the time of Moses, when God brought his people out of Egypt. Jesus was going to Jerusalem to celebrate, and Jesus and his disciples were having the Passover meal together. Jesus told them many things of what was to come and the trials they would face. Then Jesus looked up to heaven and prayed for himself, saying, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son so he can give glory back to you. I brought glory to you here on earth by completing the work you gave me to do. Now, Father, bring me into the glory we shared before the world began. Then Jesus prayed for his disciples and said, I have passed on to them the message you gave me. They accepted it and know that I came from you, and they believe you sent me. He prayed for his disciples who would be staying in the world after Jesus went to heaven. He asked God to keep them safe from the evil one and to make them holy. Then Jesus prayed for all the people who would come to believe in God because of the message that the disciples would tell. He prayed for people of all time, even to this day. He prayed that followers of Jesus would be united so that the world would believe that God sent Jesus to die for their sins so that everyone could be with God forever. The story of Easter. Jesus' sacrifice. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
The Jewish leaders and teachers did not like what Jesus was doing or how he claimed to be the Son of God. And so they made a plan to arrest him to get rid of him once and for all. Judas, one of Jesus' disciples, agreed to betray Jesus.
Come in.
And give him over to the religious leaders for some money. Jesus was in a garden praying, and Judas showed the man who Jesus was. Jesus was arrested and taken to the rulers of the land so that they could decide what to do with him. Jesus was presented before the high council, and they asked him if he was the Messiah, the Savior of the Jews. They asked him if he was claiming to be the Son of God. You say that I am. And the council was furious, and they shouted that Jesus was guilty and he deserves to die. So they took Jesus before the Roman ruler Pilate, and he heard the case against Jesus. Pilate didn't think that Jesus had done anything wrong.
Seems okay to me.
They found him to be innocent, so Pilate said that he would punish Jesus and then release him.
What?
But the crowd kept screaming louder and louder, "Crucify him! We want him dead!" And because of the pressure of the crowd, Pilate turned Jesus over to the Roman soldiers to be crucified. Jesus was hurt and spit on, his clothes were torn and taken from him, and a crown made out of thorns was put on his head. He was beaten so badly that he could barely stand on his own. And then he was forced to carry his cross so far up a mountain that he needed help because he could not do it on his own. Once Jesus made it to the place where he would be crucified, called the Skull, the soldiers around him nailed him to the cross and waited for him to die. While Jesus was hanging on the cross, many people shouted to him, "If you really are the Son of God, save yourself from the cross." But Jesus knew he had to die to forgive his people for their sins. At noon, darkness fell across the whole land. 3 hours later, Jesus took his last breath and finally died. At that very moment, the curtain in the temple that separated the priests from God's holy place tore in two. A soldier watching the whole thing said, "This man truly was the Son of God." Then a righteous man named Joseph came and placed Jesus' body in a tomb. 3 days passed, and it seemed that there was no hope. But very early on Sunday morning, the woman who cared for Jesus went to go visit his body and found that his tomb was empty and that he was no longer there. "Don't be afraid," said an angel. "He is not here. He is risen." At this, the woman remembered that Jesus had told them that he would rise again on the third day.
Woo-hoo!
And ran to go tell the disciples what they had seen and heard.
Huh?
Hey-o!
Ah!
And then for the next 40 days, Jesus appeared to his disciples and many others and showed them that he was alive and well. He taught them that what he did was the only way that they could be forgiven and be with God forever. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. Stories of the Bible. God is with us. This is Jesus.
Hey-o!
Jesus is the Savior of the world and the Son of God. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love. He healed many people from their sickness, performed many miracles, like calming storms, and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
But some people did not like what Jesus was doing. And they put him to death. He died on a cross and was buried in a tomb. For 3 days, Jesus' body laid in that tomb, and it seemed that there was no hope. But very early on Sunday morning, the woman who cared for Jesus went to go visit his body, found that his tomb was empty and that he was no longer there.
Ah!
For he was risen. He was alive.
Woohoo!
Huh? Hey-o!
Rah!
And then for the next 40 days, Jesus appeared to his disciples and many others and showed them that he was alive and well. He taught them that what he did was the only way that they could be forgiven and be with God forever. Jesus told his disciples that he did all the things that God had told everyone that he would do, and the disciples understood what he was saying.
Yep, that makes sense.
He told them that he would send the Holy Spirit, just as God had promised to be their helper.
Sounds good.
After Jesus had spent 40 days with the disciples and appeared to many people, he led the disciples to a place called Bethany. Jesus blessed the disciples and told them to go out and tell the whole world about him and the good news of forgiveness and make disciples of them. Then he said, "Be sure of this, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." Then Jesus was taken into heaven to sit at the right hand of God. Not long after that, the Holy Spirit did come to the disciples to be their helper. The disciples knew that God would truly be with them always. And the Holy Spirit is still with us today, for Jesus promised that he would be with us to the end of the age, and he is.
Awesome. I hope you guys had a lot of fun checking yourselves out with that Reader's Theater. We're going to continue on, and we have a special Easter craft from our craft connoisseur, Craftin' with Miss Iris. So check it out, follow along, send us a video of what you've done. Here it is, Craftin' with Miss Iris.
And now it's time for Craftin' with Miss Iris, the part of the show where Miss Iris comes out and does a craft.
Hey KBKidz, Miss Iris here. Are you ready for Craftin' with Miss Iris? I hope you are. So of course, Craftin' with Miss Iris, we have to have what? All of our crafting materials. So this is just going to be like free for all. I want you to really use your imagination for the craft that we're going to do today. I will show you some examples, but we are celebrating Resurrection Sunday, Easter Sunday, the Sunday where Christ rose from the dead because his work was completed here on earth. He died for our sins, he rose, and we have salvation through him. Isn't that an amazing time to just celebrate all of his good works, all of his obedience on the cross, so that we could live life here, holy before the Lord, and have eternity in heaven with our Father when we accept Jesus Christ. So, there's a lot of different ways that we can just have things that remind us of Christ's work. There's things, there's a cross, there's the empty tomb, you know, sometimes they're just springtime, just even sometimes the spring coming in reminds us that this is a time of reflection for us to remember our Lord and Savior. So I had quite a few ideas, but I want to make this all about you, KBKidz. So parents, you'll be happy to know this won't cause for too much of your attention except for our littles who need help with maybe cutting. So, go to the website. Everything that's here, that's a printout, we'll have available. You can print it out or you can just draw it yourself. I had an opportunity to be able to draw some things. So, let me show you what I did. On the website, we have the cross on the hill. We have a cross with, this is like stained glass. Sometimes if you go to some cathedral type churches, you'll see stained glass windows. It's really colorful and white.
maybe one day we'll make our own stained glass window. That might be a good craft for us. And there's also just a plain cross that you can draw and decorate as you like. So, what I did, I also did a few poems. I printed this out, this is really nice. This is scripture, 1 Peter 1:3. And it's in the shape of a cross. So maybe you may want to take your favorite scripture and write it or color it and cut it out so that it's a cross. Hang it up so that you'll be able to reflect on that. With the blank cross, this was quite fun for me. I kind of drew the crown of thorns and the decorations here, colored it. This is similar to what we did last year, but it was 3D. Because we actually use items to paste and create that with the popsicle sticks. If you were with us last year, that's what we did. So this one is an idea. And I think my favorite one is the cross on the hill. With all the starbursts coming out of it, I decided to just draw it out, print out the on the cross, Jesus said. So there are several scriptures here in Luke, Mark, and John, where he talks about the last seven sayings of Christ, the things that he spoke from his mouth while he was on the cross. I think this was my favorite because each one of those has a meaning and it represents the work that he did during his life and how it was completed and finished on the cross so that we could live in eternity with him in heaven as we accept him as our Lord and Savior. So think about what it is you want to do. What represents the resurrection for you? What is it that makes you remember the things, all the good things that Christ did for us on the cross? There's also an acrostic poem. I did a little research on that. I found one that says cross. Christ redeemed our sinful souls. So someone created that one. And since I like Jesus saves, straight to the point, I created one. Jesus saves. And this says just evangelize. And send up united songs of praise, serving our almighty, victorious, everlasting Savior. JESUSSAVES, Jesus saves. So that's just a few exercises, a few things to just get you going. But I want you, KB Kids, talk with your parents, grandparents, their families. Maybe you can create something together, maybe not. But think about what it is that you can see, something that you can look at, something tangible. Tangible means things you can touch, feel, and see that will remind you of Christ and his work on the cross. And don't forget, always bring it in or send it in and share. We love when you share, and when you share, share prizes. So hopefully you will get creative, tell us what you got, send it in, and we will see you next time. Thanks, KB Kids. Until next time, keep on crafting.
This has been Crafting with Miss Iris, the part of the show where Miss Iris comes out and does a craft.
Awesome. I hope you guys enjoyed that session, but we are not done yet. We have game time. We have trivia time. So we have a few more minutes together before we have to end this session. But check it out. Our game, our trivia.
Hi, friends. I don't know about you, but I am excited about Easter. I love celebrating the empty tomb, but you know what shouldn't be empty on Easter morning? An Easter egg! So, today we're going to play a game where you have to try to identify empty Easter eggs from an egg that is full of sweet, oh, delicious, wonderful candy. The rules are simple. I'll give you the name of a Bible character from the Easter story. Then I'll show you three Easter eggs with facts about that Bible character. Two of these facts will be wrong, but one will be true. The egg with the true answer has the candy! All you have to do is hold up the number of fingers for the egg you think has the right answer. One, two, or three. So, who's ready to go hunt for Easter eggs? Me too! Let's go! Our first Bible character is Peter. Now, which of these is true about Peter? One, Peter betrayed Jesus for money. Two, Peter denied knowing Jesus. Three, Peter washed the disciples' feet. Remember, hold up one, two, or three fingers based on which egg you think is telling the truth. Ooh, so it's not egg number one. Okay, time's up. Who is holding up two fingers? You're correct. Peter did deny that he knew Jesus three times. Ooh, you found the candy. Well done. Let's try another. Our next Bible character is Pilate. Which of these is true about Pilate? One, Pilate set Barabbas free. Two, Pilate flew planes. Three, Pilate was the chief priest. All right, which egg you think is telling the truth? So, Pilate's not a pilot. Okay, time's up. How many fingers are you holding up? You should be holding up just one because Pilate did set Barabbas free. Nice job. I'm ready to try another one. Our Bible character for this round is Judas Iscariot. Which egg is telling the truth about Judas? One, Judas betrayed Jesus for money. Two, Judas was a tax collector. Three, Judas prayed with Jesus in the garden. So, which egg do you think is telling the truth? Okay, one or three. That's it, time is up. Who is holding up three fingers? Ah, you should be holding up just one. Judas Iscariot did betray Jesus for 30 silver coins. Let's try another. Looks like our next Bible character is Simon from Cyrene. Now, which of these is true about Simon? One, Simon was Jesus's brother. Two, Simon invented Simon Says. Three, Simon carried Jesus' cross. So, which egg is telling the truth? Okay, so not a game maker. Time is up! Did you figure it out? It's egg number three! Well done! Simon did have to carry Jesus' cross. Let's try another. Our next Bible character is Mary Magdalene. Which egg is telling the truth about Mary? One, Mary was Jesus's sister. Two, Mary was the first person to see Jesus on Easter. Three, Mary never met Jesus. What do you think? One, two, or three? So she did know Jesus. Time's up! Are you holding up two fingers? If so, you're correct! Mary Magdalene was the first person to see Jesus on Easter morning. Nice job! Let's try one more. Our final Bible character is Thomas. Which egg do you think is telling the truth about Thomas? One, Thomas doubted Jesus was alive. Two, Thomas was a Roman soldier. 3. Thomas isn't in the Bible. What do you think? 1, 2, or 3? So, Thomas wasn't a soldier. Time's up! Are you holding up 3 fingers? If so, you should be holding up just 1. Thomas was a disciple and he did doubt that Jesus had really risen from the dead until he saw him with his own eyes. Excellent work, everybody! You found all of the candy eggs! Happy Easter! Good day to you all. I am Egbert Eggington IV, and I would like to egg-stand my most egg-exuberant welcome to each and every one of you. We are about to play a most egg-exciting game. It's become quite the Easter tradition in the Eggington family. The rules are very simple. Momentarily, you're going to see dozens and dozens of Easter eggs. Those eggs will soon begin to disappear to reveal an image. As soon as you think you know exactly what the image is, stand up and egg-sclaim your answer. That is, shout it out. Everyone got it? Very well, let us begin. Remember, stand up and shout it out as soon as you know what the image is. Time's up! What could this be? It's a baby chick! Oh, that reminds me. Does anyone know how most farmers make their money? With eggs, because eggs shell! Oh, that never gets old. Anyway, moving on. What do you think this could be? Shout it out if you know! Time's up! What is it? It's a chocolate bunny! Have you ever heard why chickens make their own eggs? Because they're too egg-spensive to buy! Oh my! My apologies. I have to stop. These egg jokes are cracking me up! Okay, get it together, Egbert. Get it together. Now, what do you think this image is? Time's up! What is it? It's a baby bunny! How cute! Now, all egg jokes aside, where all rabbits prefer to eat breakfast? At IHOP, of course! Anywho, what do you think this could be? Time's up! What is it? It's an Easter basket! Now, I'm sure you all have heard about the basket case down at the hospital. Oh, you haven't? Oh, it's terrible. An egg fell on a hot stove and got totally scrambled. Now, what do you think this might be? Time's up! What is it? It's a jelly bean! I've been meaning to ask. What do you call a carton of eggs that has gone bad? Egg-spired! I wonder what we're looking at here. Time's up! What is it? It's a palm branch!
I think just this once I shall waive my right to make a corny joke. Oh, wait, whoops, never mind. Again, I am Egbert Eggington IV, wishing you all a very happy Easter.
Already finished. Guys, I don't know about you, but I had a blast. Thank you so much for joining me for KBKidz Virtual Worship this week. I hope you guys were blessed. I hope you guys continue to take advantage of all the videos that we've done previous and come back next fifth Sunday. I believe it's in June. Next fifth Sunday for our next brand new KB episode. Until then, I'm going to close this out in prayer and we're going to continue on and enjoy our Easter. Let's play together. Father, we thank you for your demonstration of love to us. We are so grateful for what you've done. We are so grateful for you sending your son. We are so grateful that you saw that we were worthy even when we weren't. We pray that the story of Easter penetrates our lives each and every day, not just on today, but as we continue to go along, we share the Easter story with others so they may know about your amazing demonstration of love as well. Protect us as we continue on throughout our lives and throughout our days until we are ready to come back together and meet again and learn from you. We love you and we thank you for loving us. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. KBKidz, it has been an honor. I can't tell you how much I love worshiping with you guys, even virtually. Until next time, I hope you guys have a great week, a great Easter. If you're on spring break, if you're coming up to spring break, enjoy. Until next time, it's me, Miss D, signing off. Start to bye for now.
Positively.
Catch
we
you later,
are
friends.
Going day by day. We are watching what we say. We are kingdom builder kids and we're here to pave the way. Hey, we are kingdom builders, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKBKB say, I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. One more time, we are. I am a kingdom builder, building up the kingdom of the Lord. I am a kingdom builder. KBKidz out. Wheaton Christian Center, Kingdom Builders, Children's Ministry.